ಶ್ರೀ ಟಿವಿ ನ್ಯೂಸ್ಗೆ ಸ್ವಾಗತ. ನಾನು ರಾಧಿಕಾ. ಶ್ರೀ ಶಂಕರಾಚಾರ್ಯ ಮಂಡಲ ಪೂಜೆಯು ನಾರಾಯಣ ಸ್ವಾಮಿ ದೇವಸ್ಥಾನದಲ್ಲಿ ಕಲಾ ಹೋಮ ಮಾಡುವ ಮೂಲಕ ಜರುಗಿತು.
ದೇವಸ್ಥಾನದಲ್ಲಿ ನಾರಾಯಣ ಭಜನೆ ಮಾಡುವುದರ ಮೂಲಕ ಹೊರಬಂದಿರುವ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮದಲ್ಲಿ ಎಲ್ಲ ಆಸ್ತಿಕ ಮಹಾಶಯರು ಮಹಾದೇವರೆಲ್ಲ ಬಂದವತ್ತು ಭಜನೆ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ನಾನೀರು ಎಲ್ಲರೂ ಸಹ ಆ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮದಲ್ಲಿ ಭಾಗವಹಿಸಿ ಪ್ರತಿ ನಾಲ್ಕು ವಾರದಲ್ಲೂ ನಾವು ಪ್ರತಿ ಭಾನುವಾರದಲ್ಲೂ ನಾವು ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮವನ್ನು ಹಮ್ಮಿಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದೀವಿ. ಆ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮಕ್ಕೆ ನೀವೆಲ್ಲರೂ ಬರಬೇಕು ಮತ್ತು ಇನ್ನೂ ಹೆಚ್ಚು ಸಹಕಾರವನ್ನು ನೀಡಬೇಕು. ಮುಂದೆ ಇನ್ನೂ ಅನೇಕ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮಗಳನ್ನ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಒಂದು ದೊಡ್ಡ ಆಸೆಯನ್ನ ಇಟ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದೀವಿ. ಆ ಆಸೆಯನ್ನ ನೆರವೇರಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ನೀವೆಲ್ಲರೂ ಸಕಾಲದಲ್ಲಿ ಬಂದು ಈ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮದಲ್ಲಿ ಭಾಗವಹಿಸಿ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಒಂದು ಸಹಕಾರವನ್ನ ಸಹಾಯವನ್ನ ಹೇಳಿದ್ದೆ ಆದ್ರೆ ಇನ್ನು ಮುಂದಿನ ಹೆಚ್ಚಿಗೆ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡೋದಕ್ಕೆ ನಮಗೆಲ್ಲ ಒಂದು ಸ್ಫೂರ್ತಿ ಬರುತ್ತೆ. ಆ ಒಂದು ಶಕ್ತಿಯನ್ನು ಭಗವಂತ ಶಿವಶಂಕರ ಸ್ವಾಮಿ ಕರೆಸ್ತಾನೆ ಅಂತ ನಾನು ಭಾವಿಸುತ್ತೇನೆ. ನೀವೆಲ್ಲರೂ ಸಹ ಈ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮದಲ್ಲಿ ಯಶಸ್ವಿಯಾಗಿ ಭಾಗವಹಿಸಿ ಈ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮವನ್ನು ಉತ್ತಮ ರೀತಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ನಡೆಸಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ನೀವು ಸಹಕಾರವನ್ನು ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದೀರಾ. ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ನಾನು ನಮ್ಮ ಸಂಘದ ಪರವಾಗಿ ವೈಯಕ್ತಿಕವಾಗಿ ನಾನು ಶಿವಶಂಕರ ಸ್ವಾಮಿಗಳನ್ನು ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ಆಯಸ್ಸು ಆರೋಗ್ಯ ಐಶ್ವರ್ಯಗಳನ್ನು ಕೊಟ್ಟು ಕಾಪಾಡಲಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ಹೇಳ್ಕೊಳ್ತಾ ತಪ್ಪದೆ ಮಾನವ ದಿನ 5 ಗಂಟೆ 6 ಗಂಟೆಗೆ ಬಂದ ಸಾಕು. 6 ರಿಂದ 7 ಗಂಟೆಗೆ ತನಕ ಭಜನೆ, 7 ರಿಂದ 7:30 ಭಜನೆಯನ್ನು ಮುಗಿಸಿ ಮಂಗಳಾರತಿ ಮಾಡಿ ಅವತ್ತು ಏನು ಅವಕಾಶ ಇತ್ತು ಅಂತ ಪ್ರಸಾದವನ್ನು ವಿನಿಯೋಗ ಮಾಡತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಒಂದು ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮವನ್ನು ಸಹ ಅನ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದೀವಿ. ದಯವಿಟ್ಟು ಎಲ್ಲರೂ ಸಹ ನೀವು ಬರಬೇಕು, ಇದು ದೇವಸ್ಥಾನ ನಮ್ದು ಅನ್ನೋ ಭಾವನೆ ನಿಮಗೆ ಬರಬೇಕು. ಇವತ್ತು ಬಿಟ್ಬಿಟ್ರೆ ತಿರ್ಗಾ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ವರ್ಷಕ್ಕೆ ಬರೋದಲ್ಲ. ಇವಾಗ ನಮ್ಮ ಚೀಟಿ ಮಾಡ್ತೇವೆ ಆ ಥರ ಆಗೋದು ಬೇಡ. 12 ತಾರೀಕು ಬಂದು ತಿರ್ಗಾ 12 ತಾರೀಕಿಗೆ ಬರೋದು ಆ ರೀತಿ ಆಗೋದು ಬೇಡ. ಪ್ರತಿ ಭಾನುವಾರ ತಪ್ಪದೇ ನೀವೆಲ್ಲ ಆಗಮಿಸಿ ಆ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮದಲ್ಲಿ ಭಾಗವಹಿಸಿ ಆ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮವನ್ನು ಯಶಸ್ವಿಗೊಳಿಸಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ಮತ್ತೊಮ್ಮೆ ನಿಮ್ಮಲ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರಾರ್ಥನೆ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ತಾ ನನ್ನ ಮಾತನ್ನ ಮುಗಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ. ಜೈ ಶಿವಶಂಕರ.
ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ ಶಿಕ್ಷಣ ಇಲಾಖೆಯ ಮುಖ್ಯ ಕಾರ್ಯದರ್ಶಿಯನ್ನು ಶ್ರೀ ಟಿವಿ ಸಂದರ್ಶಿಸಿತು.
ಕನ್ನಡ
ಕನ್ನಡ ಗೊತ್ತೇ, ಬಟ್ ಐ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸ್ಪೀಕ್ ಇನ್ ಕನ್ನಡ.
ಇಂಗ್ಲಿಷ್ ಆರ್ ಹಿಂದಿ
ಸರ್? ಇಂಗ್ಲಿಷ್. ಸರ್, ಗುಡ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ನೂನ್ ಸರ್.
ಗುಡ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ನೂನ್
ಸರ್. ನವೇ ಡೇಸ್ ಎಜುಕೇಷನ್ ಕಮರ್ಷಿಯಲೈಸ್ಡ್, ಈಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಗುಡ್ ಗ್ರೋತ್?
ಎಜುಕೇಷನ್ ಶುಡ್ ನಾಟ್ ಬಿ ಕಮರ್ಷಿಯಲ್, ಇಟ್ಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್. Education is a service to society. Government institutions are there. Unfortunately, many of them are not of the required quality. Private institutions, some are of good quality, some are not of good quality, but the big problem there is fees which are not affordable for ordinary people, whether scheduled caste, scheduled tribes, backward classes, or other middle class cannot afford the fees of the private institutions. Education should be viable, but not profiteering.
Sir, in America and other countries, from starting to higher education, all educations are free. free of cost. Why we are not implementing in India?
Well, I will not be able to say why we are not implementing. That is something which you have to ask the governments.
Well, why already 70 years over after independence, still it is not implemented. For what reason for not implemented?
The importance that should be given to education, health, progress of the depressed people, backward people, that importance has not been given by successive governments of different parties. So we have to emphasize that progress of those who have been kept behind, scheduled caste, scheduled backward classes, education for all, accessible, health for all, accessible, these things have to be emphasized. Media also have a role to play in this. Unless these things are done, the country cannot progress optimally. The country has progressed, but not enough. If you look at China, they were behind us. In 1950, they became communist in 1949. We became independent in 1947. At that time, China was slightly behind us. Now they are far ahead of us. That is because they did the following things. One, land owner and landless laborer. That difference they eliminated. All people together owned agricultural lands. Second, education for all and same type of education. Health, these things they emphasized. Thereby, the people's condition improved, health improved, longevity improved. And they were able to take a leap in economic progress internationally. Their method was wrong. Their method was violent, killing people. We don't accept that. But we should democratically do the same things. Land ownership and working on land should not be separate. The tiller should be the owner of the land. All people should have land. I am not saying you should take away land from anybody. But there is plenty of government land which can be easily distributed among the landless Dalits and other landless laborers. Irrigation to be given to them so they can take 2-3 crops. That is one. And similarly, education, health, these have to be emphasized. If these things are done, India will progress optimally. It's not only good for the depressed people, but good for the country as a whole.
Government of India failure for moral education also.
You are right. Education does not mean only academic education. There has to be education about a good society, about equality, about the harm done by the caste system. Dr. Ambedkar said, caste is anti-national. This is a big nation. Caste makes our mind small. We think of only our caste. That's a small caste. So mind becomes small. How can a small mind and a big nation coexist? So our mind has to become larger. Caste has to grow. We have to recognize that all are the same. Where is the difference? You look at everybody. It's not like America, where you can look at a white man, you can say he is white. Black man, he is an African descendant. Here it is not like that. Everybody is brown. Everybody is brown, every caste is have same color. So it is the same people divided by a wrong culture of caste, and caste has ramifications. So caste became the instrument of monopoly by some, oppression of others. So this caste system has to go, caste mentality has to go, the differences created by the caste system has to go. So these are all the tasks before the country, which have been only marginally addressed, not addressed at its roots. This is a failure, not of one government, not of one political party. All political parties have are together in this failure. But we have to work through parties. In a democracy, parties are necessary. So people have to put pressure on the parties. These are things we want. If anybody brings a bottle of liquor at the time of election, that we throw at his face and say, what you want is this: land for the landless, education for all, accessible education, health for all, accessible health. Now one program is to start, we have to see how it works. It's called Ayushman Bharat, which has got two parts. One part is strengthening the existing system of government hospitals, rural hospitals, primary healthcare institutions. The other part is insurance, cashless, up to a cost of 5 lakhs cashless treatment in all hospitals. We have to see how it works. People have to watch. If it doesn't work properly, because in our system, even a good thing is corrupted. So people have to watch. If anything is not working properly, must immediately bring it to the notice of the leaders, of the governments, and also among the people. So you have to, media has to become the voice of the people, voice of the deprived people, and people who generally don't have access to what they are entitled to. So this is a task before all of us. Everybody has to perform one's duty in this direction, in whichever area you are. Mr. Ranganath in your town has contributed significantly to education of the deprived classes and rural people. So like that, everybody must come forward. Whoever has got resources, we should not swallow everything that we earn. In the Gita, there is a phrase, there is a shloka: Tair dattan apradayebhyo yo bhungte stena evasaha. Stena means thief. He who consumes by himself, whatever is given to him by them can mean God, can mean nature, can mean society, but you are being given something, and if you swallow the whole thing, you are a thief. You have to share with others. So this is what people who have got some wealth should do. People who have got knowledge, professions, they should contribute. And this, we already lost to a large extent 70 years. We cannot afford to lose more time. Population is increasing. The needs of the people are there, unsatisfied needs. More and more will be born. So we cannot afford to lose any time. So this is the task before us.
Sir, Aarogya Karnataka or Ayushman Bharat health schemes are not helps to middle class people, sir. Middle class people again suffering. What is your
advice? You see, Ayushman Bharat has started recently, only in October.
Yes, sir.
You please watch. How is it working? Then Karnataka scheme, you know how, where it is not working. Is it, I don't know about the details of the scheme, is it cashless insurance?
Not cashless, is it cashless insurance?
Cashless insurance. Then.
But our government hospitals are not upgraded for that level. Eh?
Yeah, yeah. See, that is because in the budgets, we don't provide enough money for people's needs like health. Bangladesh, which is a poorer country, which is a country far behind us in many matters, they have provided for health a larger, much larger percentage of their GDP than we provide. We provide only about 0.9% of our GDP for health. Well, Bangladesh provides some
6%.
In India, Kerala has a long tradition not only after independence, even before independence started, gradually it grew. There is a good infrastructure of health. So this infrastructure of health in rural areas and small towns has to be developed. And unless that infrastructure is there, scheme coming from above will not percolate to the people. So what you said is right, that hospitals are not up to the standard, therefore they are not able to get the, and they have to go to distant hospitals. So this is something which people have to demand from successive governments. Governments are formed by parties and they are fighting with each other. In Hindi it is called tutu bhame. This party says you are a thief, that party says you are a thief, who is the greater? So this is not a real development. And again poaching and all that. This is not the game for which democracy exists. So people must tell the parties, look, we want you to work. This is what you want. We are at this level. When you talk about health, hospitals are not working. Make the hospitals work. Put the budget, adequate budget and adequate machinery for that. So this is the demand that people must make. Unless you demand, unless the people demand, correctively, powerfully, peacefully, no violence, no bad language, but strong demand that we want this. When MLAs come, now candidates will come for election for Lok Sabha, they must ask these things. Will you do this? Will you do this? Will you do this? Take it in writing. So that if they win, then you can go to them and say, you signed this, now do this. If you are in the opposition, then you please build up your pressure. Both have their duty. Ruling party also has got its duty. Opposition party also has got its duty. But it all depends on people's ability to mobilize and demand specific things. I have prepared a roadmap. A copy is with Professor Shivalingam. You can also get it. What should be done for scheduled caste, scheduled tribes, backward classes? So they can become equal to the forward caste in every measurement, every parameter. This does not mean there are also poor people among the forward caste. They must also be helped, but helped in the proper way. Not reservation, but scholarships, education loans, skill development, so they can also set up their business and other things, young people. So this is a culture we have to build up.
Sir, in our government hospital,
yeah,
we have a very good scanning machine.
Yeah.
But from past 3 years, nobody can come to work here. Because government ready to pay 1.5 lakhs, 2 lakhs, 1.5 lakh up to 1.5 lakhs. But nobody interested. Because all are not service oriented people.
See, people who have grown up in cities will not like to go to small towns. So what should be done is, from every town, small town, you must pick up students, best students, and bring them to the medical colleges, so they will go back to their own towns. In Hyderabad, there is a very backward area called the Charminar area, in old Hyderabad. Most of the people there are Muslims. They are very backward Muslims. They are backward communities of Muslims. See, among Muslims also, there is a caste system. In 2007, on my recommendation, 4% reservation was introduced for 14 Muslim backward communities. They were Muslims, but they were community, not all Muslims. And that was introduced as working till now. Every year, from the Charminar area, 100 to 150 boys and girls are coming out of medical colleges. And they are going back, and many of them are working in the same place, in underserved place. In Kerala, in the plantation area, there was a school where nobody was passing, everybody was failing. that was brought to my notice by a judge in his judgment in some case. So I went there and then I recommended the government, no teacher who is trained and posted here comes here. They apply for leave, then they try to get transferred to some other place. So take people of this area who have the minimum qualification and post them. Don't go by who is the that selection of the whole state will not work. So you select people from here who will work in this place. Thereafter they are getting number of, nobody is failing and they are getting number of first classes. In Andhra Pradesh, in the tribal area, there is the same problem. No teacher will go to tribal area and work. So I advised the chief minister then, and he also accepted it. And we picked up candidates from the tribal area, reduced the qualification, doesn't matter, for teaching class 4. I don't require a graduate. I can have a matriculate or even a pre-matriculate. So we appointed such people with reduced qualification, adequate qualifications for teaching in that area on condition that they must pass the qualifying examination within 5 years. So for people's development, we must try to get people from the same area, teachers, doctors, and post them there. They will work there. A boy or a girl from Sira who has got roots here will be willing to work. At least out of 10 people, at least 5 people will work here. So this also is something which you must take up with your government. Yeah. The problem you mentioned is correct, but it's not only in Sira. All over India there's a problem. Nobody who is grown up in big cities like Bangalore or Delhi will be willing to go to a small town. So for that we should have a separate policy. Select people from these areas and have the condition that they will go back and work there. But mere conditions won't work. People must have, if a person from Sira would like to come back here, am I right?
Yes.
Yeah. So this is the effort that you people have to make. Media has a big contribution to make. Don't waste your time in the stories of poaching and then these are small things. Big things are how people should progress and their needs should be met. Concentrate on that. Yeah. It's a very good thing that you have got a local channel. Yeah. But your voice must reach Bangalore.
Yes.
Your voice must reach Delhi.
Sure, sir. We work same thing.
Yeah.
They are working in the desired manner, sir.
Very good. Very
they are mainly focusing towards the deprived and deprived classes of the society.
Very good.
Toilets in every home.
We are searching and we are exposed to that concert department and we will rectify.
ಇಂದಿನ ವಾರ್ತಾ ಪ್ರಸಾರವನ್ನ ಮುಕ್ತಾಯ ಮಾಡೋಣ. ನಿರಂತರ ಸುದ್ದಿಗಾಗಿ ನೋಡ್ತಾ ಇರಿ ಶ್ರೀ ಟಿವಿ. ಇದು ಜನಪರ ಧ್ವನಿ.